Hi friends, this is Kevin. With me today, we have three very important guests. We have David, who's the creator of SignalR library. We have Damian, who's a core maintainer of the very popular open source library called Socket.io. And we have Ken, who's the engineering manager of an Azure service called Azure SignalR service. The three of them and the code they write power a large number of real-time web apps on the internet. So without further ado, David, would you like to take it away?
I am David Fowler. I am a distinguished engineer on the .NET team. And me and one of my coworkers built this library called SignalR, I think it was 12 years ago now. I made the project. I remember I was working on this software that was kind of like Live Share, and Live Share is this app where you can open code in the browser or an IDE or VS Code, and multiple people can contribute to an app at the same time. So it's like pair programming, but in real time. And I have been interested in trying to figure out what made these kinds of apps work. And I learned about techniques like long polling and HTTP streaming. And eventually I landed on, there was a new spec being built at the time, and it was called WebSockets. And I got really interested, and eventually the framework that I was using to build the application became more interesting than the application itself.
So I'm Damien Arrachequesne, software engineer, and I wanted to create a multiplayer game, and back in 2015, and I end up with Socket.io and created a basic game. So the game, I didn't finish the game, but I ended up with Socket.io, and started maintaining and the project.
Yeah, my name is Ken. So I'm the engineering manager of SignalR service. I remember it's back in 2018. So I remember at that time we were looking for some opportunities to turn some of the popular open source libraries into Azure managed services. So we actually looked into different popular open source libraries, where we just turn SignalR into an Azure service. So it's actually a Microsoft first party library, and we have David Fowler, who is the creator of this library to help us.
Reminds me of a recent conversation I had with Scott Hanselman. Damien, if you don't know Scott Hanselman is another very important colleague at Microsoft. He's done so much for the open source community. But anyways, I really like the way he described the relationship between WebSocket, library, and also the service. So WebSocket at the very bottom provides the mechanism of bidirectional communication between the server and the clients. And libraries like SignalR library and Socket.io, they provide additional features like room or group so that developers can manage connections as a single unit. This brings them closer to the problem space they're thinking about. And with a service, it abstracts away the underlying management of client connections. Damien and David, I would like to learn a bit more about the APIs and features provided by the library.
Yeah, so SignalR provides this RPC remote procedure call abstraction, where I can call a method between client and server. That's normal, right? If you want to make a request from the client to the server, let's say you're in the browser and you want to get information from your server, you would build an HTTP API on the server side, and the client would do a fetch or do some kind of call to get the response. That works fine if you wanted a single response. But what if you wanted every time there was a score update? So imagine you have this live dashboard. Every time you wanted a score update, you would have to make calls to the server, polling every single time. So you're doing this request response over and over and over. SignalR allows you to say, whenever data is ready on the server side, you're going to call this method on the client. and it kind of flips the entire paradigm on its head of being able to just call from client to server. SignalR enables you to call from server to client. And that was the unique thing that it did that enabled you to devs to kind of build these applications without having to think about what transport was there, how hard it was to kind of like manage connections or manage state over these polling intervals or scale out.
Most definitely, application developers, they don't like to work at the network layer. They want to focus on their applications. They want to build it fast. They want to build it more reliably. So that is the promise of SignalR library and also Socket.io library. It provides the mechanism of real-time communication between server and the client. And like what you said, David, this connection can be established through HTTP, can be established through WebSocket, and can be established through web transport. And that is a recent addition to Socket.io as well. Damien, would you like to talk more about it?
Yeah. That's something we will try to talk even more about now, because it's new. It's support for web transport was added in last year, I think, in Chrome. And so basically, it's WebSocket, but on top of UDP. Instead of TCP, you have UDP. So for some workloads like games, it's much more efficient. So yes, we have brought support for web transport in June, I think, and we need to give even more examples about it, because it's the new way of talking between a server and multiple clients.
When my colleagues and I were thinking about this space, we definitely see the web is going more dynamic and a more real time. Initially, the web was very, very basic. It's all about static content. Later, we wanted to do commerce. We wanted to do chat. We wanted to do social media. Just look at all the popular apps we see these days on the market. They usually have an element of real time to it. And we see this trend will continue because end users will demand a more dynamic web. And this will drive developers to bring those innovations to the table. I'm very curious about what's the next step for SignalR library and the Socket.io library, and how the rest of the community can get involved.
So the SignalR library has been around for 12 plus years now, and you would think, man, it's done. Real time is over. WebSockets is pervasive. We're fine. The web never stays still. The web always evolves, and there are new transports that are more efficient and offer more benefits every day. So SignalR, one thing we always do is we keep up to date with web standards. So there's a new transport called web transport that effectively lets you do UDP and TCP over HTTP2 and HTTP3. And they solve some very low level fundamental issues that HTTP kind of has when you're trying to use it with these long running connections. The other feature I'm super excited about is stateful reconnect. This has been a long request from people that have used SignalR in unreliable situations and networks. SignalR is used in a ton of what we call occasionally connected devices, where you're on your phone and maybe you're going through a tunnel and you've lost connections, so you change networks from mobile to Wi-Fi. And you don't want to lose the state of your connection. So in old SignalR, you had to manually write the code to reconnect whenever a connection dropped. And when you're in those environments where you're not always connected, it was painful. So we offered this new feature in .NET 8 called Stateful Reconnect, where the connection tries its best for some time frame, which is configurable, to reconnect over and over and over, buffering your information until it reconnects. So imagine you're on an app, you're playing a game with your friend, and you go through a tunnel, and you've lost connection, and you come out the other side, and you've reconnected. You won't lose state. All your moves will be replayed, and things will kind of catch up to where they were before. That's a feature that I am looking forward to making people's lives a lot easier using library. And there's a slew of other features as well coming in. Client results was one that I really kind of love and I'm watching people use. So there's a lot of innovation still left to be had in this space that I'm looking forward to.
So the next steps now, I think we're missing a lot of more ambitious examples and maybe videos or such to help new users to come into the Node.js world and start real-time apps, start building real-time applications. So anything that could help the community is on the to-do list. I'm working on this. We have the chance to have a lot of feedback from the users for new features or bug. We have a great backlog of new features that we could add to the Socket.io library. If people want to get into this, you can help also develop other client implementations. We support, we have a lot of clients implementations right now, but Golang, Java, C++, Rust, Python, but as more and more languages appear, it's always, we need some help to maintain those libraries.
So currently there are a few things our sales team is currently doing. We have geo replication, cross regions support in preview. So we actually heard a lot of customers. They have their customers in different regions, so they want to they can easily connect to Azure within the minimum latency. We are working on improving the capacity of the SignalR service. For example, currently the maximum connection count is like 100,000 connections, which should be enough for most of customers, but there are still customers who have very extreme demands. We are working on this kind of support. The other one is we actually want to expand our scope. Started a new offering 2 years ago, which is called Web Pops Up, which supports generic WebSockets. And recently we actually worked together with Damian to add this new native support for Socket.io on Azure.
Now that you've allowed us to go behind the scenes, I really understand how much it takes to providing these libraries and service to developers. A big thank you for your work.